Hi guys! Okay, so I'm finally doing my first video, which is going to be my July favorites. Get excited. I'm just going to jump right into it, and okay, so here we go. So first things I'm going to tell you about are my favorite kind of like beauty items this month, and the first thing that I absolutely love, Daisy by Marc Jacobs. I don't know if you can see that. I love the bottle, the full-size bottle with the flowers on top and all that, and I actually have used Lola for the longest time, but I kind of feel like Lola is a little bit more grown-up version of Daisy, and I like a little bit softer scents, and Lola's nice for going out at night and everything, but I think Daisy's a great day scent because it's a little lighter, a little more flowery. I don't know, I'm terrible at describing scents, but I don't know. It reminds me of baby powder, but like a good baby powder, not, I don't know. Fresh, just go smell it. Anyway, I went to Sephora thinking I was gonna buy the whole big perfume bottle, and I actually decided to get the rollerball version, which is this little cute little guy. I decided on the rollerball just because I travel a lot. I live in New York City right now, but my whole family lives in Chicago, so whenever I fly, I can't bring my whole huge perfume bottle because I'm scared to put it in my carry-on because I'm scared it'll get broken, and then obviously, wait, that was wrong. Rewind. Okay. I'm scared to put it in my checked bag because I'm scared it'll get broken. Because they just throw those bags around like crazy. They like treat your luggage so bad. Anyway, but I'm scared to do that, obviously. And then I can't bring it on my carry-on because it's too much liquid. It's a sad day. So this will be good because I can actually bring it in my carry-on or throw it on my other bag and it probably won't get broken because it's pretty sturdy. It's just like a little rollerball pen. Anyway. Buy it. I'm pretty sure this was like $20 at Sephora, which is a really good deal because you get a lot of perfume. Alright, moving on. So my next thing is, I don't know if any of you are familiar with Murad products, but they kind of have been like a lifesaver for me, and I know my lighting's kind of bad right now. You can't really see like my skin tone or anything, but I have really, really, really fair skin with freckles. Like you can see my freckles kind of up there. I don't know. Anyway, I'm super freckly and white, and my boyfriend's actually gonna come and adjust my lighting for me, so hopefully the next video will be better lit, because right now I look kind of like pink or orange or yellow or something. So I love Murad products. They're like a lifesaver for me. They're a little bit more expensive, but they're so worth it to have good skin, and my favorite lotion for them of all time is their Skin Perfecting Lotion. Oh, it's so white. I don't think you can... There we go. Hydrate, Protect, Skin Perfecting Lotion. For optimal results, follow with recommended Murad sunblock during the day. Sunblock is huge for me. I'll do a whole video on sun care and sunblock, and let me know in the comments below if you want me to do a video on that, because I am so fair, but I love the beach. I love it so much, and hold on, my computer's gonna die. So like I was saying, I love the beach, but my skin tone is just not built for it. I'm fair, freckly, Irish roots, and so... sunscreen is huge, and Murad sunscreen is awesome, but definitely expensive, so I actually use Neutrogena usually. But I'll do a whole video on that, and I have a really great sunless tanner I use, and yeah. Anyway, this is awesome, and it's really light, and it actually smells pretty good. Let me put this guy on my nose. It doesn't break me out. I have really sensitive skin, and it doesn't break me out, but you only need like a small amount. I put like a dime size on my face and my neck, and it rubs and blends really great, and yeah, I just recommend this. It's like $33, which is kind of expensive, but it lasts you a really long time. So my other thing that goes along with that is my acne treatment concealer in light. Anyway, it's Murad, and it's got 2% salicylic, I think that's how you say it, salicylic acid in it. And basically, you just put it on your zits, you know, any pimples or acne marks you have, you put it on, and I use a different concealer under my eyes. Do not use it under your eyes. It's not made for the delicate skin under your eyes, so definitely just use it on like your zits, like on your chin or any problem areas on your forehead. I put it on before I put on any makeup. It's the first thing I do after my moisturizer and that dries and like eye cream. I put this on. I will say it doesn't cover quite as well as maybe like, I don't know, a different concealer. It doesn't cover quite as well as I would like it to, but I do notice that it does clear my pimples up. If I have a pimple and I put this on underneath my foundation, I do notice that the next day it's smaller and the red marks are gone, and it kind of like clears up faster. So I recommend it. I don't know, maybe my mind will change and I'll find, stumble upon something better. Let me know what concealer you guys use, those of you that have sensitive skin, because I would really like to, I'm curious, try some new concealers. But either way, these two products together, awesome. Murad makes awesome stuff. Oh, I think this was like $22. Okay, next product, I'm sure that you guys have all heard about. It actually just came out like last week, end of July. So I guess it is a July favorite only because I discovered it end of July and I've been using it for the past 2 weeks, and I just want to put it in here because I'm really excited about it. It comes in a box that looks like this. I kept the box for you guys. It's Beyond Mascara, Their Real Benefit. And it's their brand new mascara that they just came out with. Anyway, I was a little skeptical at first, but I had to try it because anything new, I love mascaras, and I just had to try it. And I usually swear by the drugstore brand Maybelline Great Lash, and I know it's a hit or miss. You either love it or hate it. I've read a lot of people who hate it, but I love it. It works great for my eyes, and it's affordable. It's like $5 at the Rite Aid down the street. So, but this is a little more expensive, obviously. This is what the bottle looks like. And it's just a sleek, kind of silvery, shiny bottle, and it says, they're real. Yeah, they are. And I'll show you what the wand looks like. So it's just kind of like regular, like straight. There's no curve to it, but then the end has these little, like, I don't know if you can see that. It has these little, like, prickles on it. Like, a little more, like, these little, like, prickles on it. That kind of like, it looks like a plant to me, like a cactus kind of at the head of it. And it's the specially designed brush reveals lashes you never knew you had. You're supposed to position the hand wand horizontally and wiggle it from side to side like this when you put a little on. I'm actually wearing this right now. I don't know if you can tell, but my eyelashes are super long. It really works, you guys. I would definitely recommend it. And then once you do that, you're supposed to vertically stroke upward. That's what the little bobbles are for at the end. So like this. Oh my God, I'm totally not doing a very good job. But a little trick I learned with mascara is that I like to go like this at the end of every time and kind of like, I don't know how to explain how I just did that, but just on the tips of my eyelashes to make them kind of go out. Like, do you see how they kind of like go out of my eye? It's because I go like this with the wand when I'm done, I just kind of like drag it over the edges. It gets a little bit of the bottom and the top, and it just kind of like flares them out a little at the edge. And I just love that look. I think it's so pretty. So try that with your mascara. You don't need to use a mascara like this. You can use any mascara to flail them out. And maybe this is like a trick everyone knows, but I don't think anyone taught it to me. I just kind of started doing it. So, yeah. So, I need to show you guys one more thing. This is something you guys probably already heard about, which is the Bumble South Surf Spray. Bumble Surf Spray. Yeah. I love this stuff because look at my hair. Doesn't it look like I just got back from like the beach? Nope, I didn't. I got out of the shower and I went spritz, 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 spritz. My hair is completely dry right now. And it just kind of like gave it like this beautiful wave. Now, mind you, I have naturally wavy hair, but it's like not this crimpy. Like, look how crimpy it is underneath. Look at that. That's crazy curl, huh? It's super crimpy. It looks like I crimped it with a crimping iron, but I didn't. And it's just, I mean, I know it's super messy, but it's a summer, hot summer day here. It's New York City, so it's really hot and like heat's radiating off of the concrete. And so just, I don't want to use any heat on my hair. And I didn't. I just let it dry naturally with this. The one thing I will say about this spray is it's kind of expensive for a little bottle. And the other thing is that it really dries your hair out. I noticed that my hair feels like crunchy and dry after I use it, and I'm like, ugh, I don't like that. But it's worth it to get the look you want. I don't know. It depends. I like it, but I kind of want to try the other one, which is Not Your Mom's Surf Spray. You can't get it in New York. I can't find it anywhere. I'm sure you can find it somewhere. If someone lives in New York and knows where I can get that, Not Your Mom's Beach Spray, I think it's called. It's supposed to be at Walmart, but there's not a Walmart around here. There's no Walmart. There's a Kmart. I tried Kmart. They didn't have it. I tried Target. They didn't have it. So it's like the one time I miss Walmart for products like that. I really want that because this is kind of expensive. I was actually gifted this by a friend, so I didn't even buy it. I really wanted the Not Your Mom's, but I didn't really have the heart to purchase this on my own, so I totally understand if you don't want to get it, but I just love the wave that it creates. you guys, this is the longest video ever. I'm so sorry. Okay, I'm going to move away from beauty stuff now, and I'm going to move on to some clothing items I love. Like I said, I live in New York, but my family lives in the Chicago suburbs, and I don't know if you guys have ever heard of a store called Charming Charlie's. It's just jewelry, and they have, like, all types of jewelry and purses and kind of, like, accessories and fun things. Anyway, my mom came and visited me, and she brought me this necklace from Charming Charlie's, and I just think it's beautiful. It's, like, gold. Isn't that so cute? It's a mirror, you guys. That's the back, and then I'll turn around. Sorry if I blind you. But look at that. It's a mirror. Like, you can wear this around your neck and then, like, look in the mirror and, like, check your teeth or check your makeup, and I just think it's so adorable. It's like, it's just so pretty. And it's gold, and I love like gold jewelry because it reminds me of like vintagey stuff. Like, I think gold is better than silver for my skin tone too. Like, I don't know, it's just so pretty. And I don't know how much it was, but I'm pretty sure it was cheap because Charming Charlie's is not very expensive. So if any of you guys know Charming Charlie's, go there and buy jewelry because they have really cute stuff. Okay, the next thing is, walking around in the city in the summer in flip-flops is terrible. The streets are so dirty, your feet like end up black. I don't know about you guys, but I walk around and I come home and my feet are just black and I have flip-flops on. I'm like, I didn't step in anything crazy. Like, why are my feet so black? So I decided that I was gonna wear mostly flats this year, and I actually found these flats at the Gap, which I don't shop at the Gap that much, but you guys, I won this contest at Gap to get 50% off everything for the entire year. I don't ever win anything, so it was like crazy. Like, I went into the Gap and I entered this contest and I actually won. Who does that? So I went into Gap and I bought these, which you can't tell what it is yet, but look at this cute little bag. It's like a travel bag and it's silver and like shimmery. Like, I don't think you can tell. Oh yeah, there you go. See? And you can just throw this in your purse if you're like wearing heels out for the night, or you're like wearing flip-flops and then you're like, oh, this is gross, I need to put on like flats. And then you just pull out, you open the bag and you pull out these city flats. That's what they're called. They're called Gap City Flats. And look at that. They're kind of grody, you guys, because I've been wearing them so much. But look, they're so cute and they are so comfortable, you guys. I don't know why they're so comfortable. I usually hate flats like this, but this does not dig into your feet as much. I went a half a size up than what I normally get. I'm usually 7.5 and these are 8s. But honestly, they're so worth it. They're so comfortable. And this is like so padding. The padding on the bottom is awesome. And they're really cute. They look adorable on. So I recommend these. I got 50% off, so they were like $15. I think they're usually like 30 bucks, but they might be on sale right now because everything like summery is on sale. And they have these in so many different colors. I totally recommend these. So I have one more thing to show you, which is just my favorite bikini I've been wearing all summer, which is by Becca Swimwear. And I got it at Macy's for 50% off. And look at that. Look how cute that is. It's like a little ruching right there. You can't really see, but it kind of pulls up and it's like a full skirt around. Look how cute that is. It's so cute and it's so colorful and fun. I just went to the beach last week in this and I felt like I looked so good. Not that I like ever think I look really good in a bikini, like whatever. Like, most bikini bottoms don't really flatter my figure because I'm pretty curvy, but these are adorable and my boyfriend loves them, which is really all that matters, right? And I'm actually gonna do a whole video on like things your boyfriend will appreciate, because boyfriends don't really appreciate like crazy makeup and stuff half the time. Like, he just likes it when I wear like natural, and I know a lot of other boyfriends are like that too. But I will do a whole video on things that your boyfriend appreciates, because my boyfriend actually kind of likes fashion, shocker shocker. So I will do a video. Anyway, off topic, these bikini bottoms are awesome and you can pair any top with these. I just put like a plain like Roxy black halter, but you can pair like a purple, a blue, a green. Those colors are gorgeous and the pattern is so cute. And I just love the ruffly skirt. So girly and fun. Okay, so that's it for my July favorites. I know it was a long video. Thanks for bearing with me, you guys. I'm going to be doing more videos. So I hope you guys like it. And leave a comment below and tell me what kind of videos you want me to do. Because living in New York, I have access to a lot of things. And if you guys want to know more about what it's like to live here or my life, I would love to tell you. Thanks for watching. I'm really excited to be doing this. And I hope to make some awesome friends on YouTube. And yeah, that's it. Happy July, guys. Wow, losing my mind. Happy August. It's August, and it's my birthday month. So, yeah, I hope to talk to you guys soon, and I'll be making another video shortly. Mwah! Bye.